Hi guys, welcome to my home office. I'm sure many of you have recently turned random rooms into home offices. It's working out okay though. So I'm just coming to you from my home office to share with you just a few things that I personally have been experiencing. So Will asked, what has God been saying in all of this? And it's interesting because I haven't received something new to share with you, but I will share with you what I received that God reminded me that He gave me in preparation for all of this. And it's quite remarkable, I think, anyway. So we'll see what you think. Back in December, I went to a prayer meeting with a group of women, and during this time, we were challenged to take an hour and get away with the Lord and listen to see what He has to say. And during that time, I was reading various scriptures and I was sitting outside, which I love to do. I always feel more connected. I'm not, I'm just as connected indoors, but it's just an emotional thing for me, I guess. And I specifically heard God give me this one word. Now, God's been giving me one words pretty regularly, and this one word that He gave me was restoration. And when He gave it to me, I wrote it down and I clearly heard Him say, "This isn't just for you. You need to share it. It's for others as well." And I was like, okay. Now, I immediately began to think for the women that were in this place, how could it apply to them? And I felt like I got some insight for one woman in particular, and I shared that on that day. Little did I know that this one word was going to be so important as we got into 2020, and more specifically in the last month or two. So the word restoration simply means to return something to its original condition. And I tell you, that has brought me great peace during this whole time. And when fear begins to creep in, as it does, and I'm able to remind myself that you have to subject yourself to the Holy Spirit. And then, B, God gave me this one word that restoration, things would be restored to its original condition. And I've been holding on to that. One other thing that He gave me was back at the end of February, I went to a story rope retreat. And in that time, we were challenged to get alone with God to determine what our story rope was going to mean. And I got up early one morning and snuck out of my room and went downstairs, opened up the Bible to just, this random passage in Psalms. I love the Psalms. And He led me to Psalm 91. And I have it pulled up here, so I'm going to read it to you, just a piece of it. "He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence." And I always personalize that and I say, "Surely you will save me from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence." And what's going on right now is deadly pestilence. And God just keeps reminding me that He gave me that scripture back in February before I even knew we were going to be going through all of this as intensely as it has been. So, two things to encourage you today. Restoration, God promises to return things to its original condition. And then claim Psalm 91 over yourself. Read it out loud daily. Remind the enemy that your God is still in control. And remind yourself, your own soul, not to be fearful during this time, because although we may not understand it, God does have a plan in all of this, and His plans are always good. It's the enemy who comes seeking to kill and destroy, not God. God's plan is always to turn what's bad into something beautiful. So I hope this encourages you today, and reach out to me. I'm available. I ain't doing very much. I would love to pray with you, pray for you, or just listen. Thanks, guys. Take care.